On this very special episode of the Magnifying Glass, I talked with the great Sarmad Ghafoor. Sarmad is one of the biggest names in the Pakistani music industry with his production and guitar work. He has played and produced for the likes of Atif Aslam, played on Coke Studio both as a musician and member of the house band, as well as in one of Pakistan's biggest ever rock bands, Qayaas, amongst many others. Let's meet Sarmad.
Assalamu alaikum. Today we are here with the great Sarmad Ghafoor, one of the biggest producers and musicians in Pakistan. He has worked with the likes of Atif Aslam and Qayaas, and amongst many others. He's personally one of my heroes and my inspirations. I'm a huge fan. So let's welcome Sarmad bhai to the show and put him under the magnifying glass. How are you today?
I'm well. Thank you for having me.
Firstly, I want to ask you, how did you get into music in the first place?
I had no inclination towards music, but when I was young, my brother used to play the guitar, and it used to be pretty boring, especially the afternoons. Back in the day, we had like, you know, PTV, and we would start somewhere around 4:30. So there was no television before that. It was pretty boring at that time. And there used to be a guitar lying around, and there was a book I remember on it said how to play the guitar, and I just picked it up, and then my brother taught me a few chords, and I used to strum those chords, and he used to solo over those chords. So that's how I got into playing.
Does your brother still play? Is he a musician still?
Yes, okay. Yes. My brother is his name is Sarmad Ghafoor. He's from the band Sarmad and Zeeshan.
Yes, they do English songs, right? Yes, that's I didn't know he was your brother. I think I read that this morning or just a while back. I didn't know that. So, everyone in music in Pakistan seems to be linked one way or another.
It's a very small community. Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. So your primary instrument is the guitar. What drew you towards the guitar? And did you learn any other instruments after that or not?
Yes, the guitar is my principal instrument. I don't really get to play it as much as I want to. Mm. I also did learn a bit of the piano. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I can play a bit of bass and a bit of drums. And I also play another instrument, which you can probably see here. It's called the instrument.
Yeah, I've seen Zulfi bhai post on Facebook about that instrument a lot. So, electronic based instrument, right?
Yeah. As you can do whatever you want with it.
Is it a bit like MIDI?
It is MIDI, but it's an MP MIDI controller. MP stands for MIDI polyphonic expression. And what that helps you do is you have like an expression for each and every note. Unlike a MIDI keyboard where you have just one expression for all the keys, you have like expression for each key. So that's what separates from it.
Interesting. So you talked about the piano. So on the piano, that's you?
Yeah.
I think Umeed thi ya Pukar tha?
Pukar.
That was good melodies over. We'll talk about Uspar and Qayaas afterwards. So sure. Let's talk about Rang. How did you form Rang, and who was in Rang, and how was that whole experience?
Yeah, so basically we were friends with, back in the day, even right now I'm friends with Farhad Humayun. And me, my brother, and our band, at that time it was called Still. We were.
It's Fawad Mai from Overload, right?
Yeah. Exactly. So we were over at his place, and we met Ifu, the lead vocalist for Run. And he was very interested in making a band with my brother. But my brother was busy, so he asked me to, you know, why don't you do something with him? And I was like, yeah, I'd love to. So I visited Ifu. And we jammed and we formed Rang. It was a great experience jamming with him. And we wrote quite a few songs.
Album Dream, right?
That's correct.
So we, how come that didn't pursue ek album ke baad you guys broke up or what
album ke baad, asal mein, the problem was ki we weren't really getting enough business, we weren't getting enough concerts. Mm. And that basically made us sort of like go our separate ways because it wasn't going anywhere. Yeah.
Okay.
But otherwise, we're still friends and whatnot.
That's good. Aksar bands, especially in Pakistan, lots of breakups and very fighting bad terms. So I don't know ye kyun hota hai lekin Pakistan bands maine ye note ki aksar all my favorite brands, almost all of them tend to break up, and for the fan it's pretty sad. Who is Ifu? What's his full name?
Ifu's full name is Iftikhar Habib.
Okay, I haven't heard of him, but yeah, I have heard a few Rang songs though. Very different sound theme.
Yeah, different sound, and his book, I mean, he's an amazing vocalist though. I really, really love his tone, his range, his expression, and it was a lovely experience working with him.
So let's move on to Qayaas now. So I was talking to Khurram bhai, and what he told me, it was the four of them. And then he asked you to come on board, and you loved the idea. And then you wrote Halak for the album. You wrote a few solos as well, and you helped in the mixing and mastering for the album. So how was the Qayaas? How did you enter Qayaas? How was the whole experience like?
Yeah, so that's pretty much it. They had already like written most of the album, and they asked me to join, and I loved the idea because I love everyone in the band. They're all great friends. So it was, it was a natural thing for me to say yes. And I joined them, and then we finished the album, and we did quite a few concerts. It was a lovely experience.
Yeah, Khurram bhai was saying the same thing. Personally, Uspar is one of my all-time favorite records. I just love every song on Uspar. So, which brings me to my next question, the breakup of Qayaas. It was heartbreaking for me because I loved Uspar, I was a huge fan of the band. So I remember during, I asked Khurram bhai the same thing, during this, you were working on the second album, and I remember a Facebook post, it was something about like infighting or something about someone controlling a lot of the music, or there was some issues within the band. So why did Qayaas break up?
I don't remember any such post. I don't know, maybe it was like speculation on someone else's
maybe
part.
Khurram bhai put it down to gossip in media.
Okay, maybe, yeah, that's what it was. But no, there wasn't any fighting as such. I mean, we basically three of us left the band. It was me, Fifu, and Sherry. I can only speak for myself. I basically could not give it the time and attention that it required. I was busy with touring with Atif and paying my bills and whatnot. So I just couldn't attention it required. Basically, paying my bills. Was busy with production. You know how you have responsibilities. You have to pay the bills no matter what. So I could not give it the attention it required, and then I had to sort of like decide to.
So basically, Qayaas was so much of your own passion project thing, but the production thing was more your like day job where you put food on the
table.
So is pe baat aa gayi thi. That's very sad, actually. So
it
even
sad,
I guess for you as well, because aapka khud band tha, wo khud dil usme tha, aur you had to do this other stuff. Even though I guess you would have liked to do. You enjoy the other stuff, but apna band ki baat hoti hai.
Apna band. So, apni identity hoti hai. Apna band jo hai na. There's so nothing like it in the world.
Exactly. So after you left Qayaas, unko teen name members aaye the, but that album, the second album, still did not come to fruition. Why do you think that was?
I don't know, because when the second album was being made, I mean, I left somewhere in the beginning of that. So I don't know what happened.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So Qayaas,
I do know that. I do know that they recorded a lot of stuff, Omar and Khurram, but I don't know what happened to that stuff though.
Okay. Uspar pe ek aur bawaat ki, did you have any production in Uspar or was it all Khurram bhai?
Matlab, I Well, it was a mix of both. Almost all the guitars and the bass was recorded at Khurram's. And vocals, I'd say some were recorded at my studio, some at his. The drums were all recorded at mine. And then me and Khurram, we mixed it. Mixed and mastered it together.
Fair enough. So let's move on from KK.
You can say that most of the production was done at Khurram's.
Yeah, that's what he told me as well. Let's move on from Qayaas. I want to get more into your productions side. So how does being a producer differ from being a musician?
A producer has to look at the bigger picture. He has to look at the song, what's suiting the song. A musician is more concerned about his parts and basically his role as a musician, just focusing on one small part. Producer has to look at the bigger picture.
So which part do you enjoy more?
I enjoyed being a musician, but now that I'm not in practice, I think production is a natural thing for me. I just don't have the time to practice anymore. And being a musician means that, you know, you need to really be practicing your scale all the time, be in form.
Do you think you ever go back to being a musician?
I would love to. I just don't know if I can anymore. Yeah.
I would love for you. I will. The solo stuff you put out, we'll talk about that as well. At least that's something. So let's come to Atif Aslam. How did you meet Atif and how was it working with him on Jalpari?
Right. So I met Atif through Farhad Humayun again. And he brought him to Islamabad and he wanted to record his album very quickly.
This was after Jal broke up, right?
Yes, this is right after Jal broke up. And we recorded the whole thing in 4 days. I had a friend. I mean, I still have a friend. His name was Wasim. And he had a place in F6. And we had set up a studio over there. So we recorded him in 4 days. Wasim tracked the whole thing. And then he gave me all the files. And I mixed everything in a week. And played the guitars on them and whatnot. So, yeah. So it was lovely meeting Atif and listening to him for the first time. He had a great voice and great songs. And I was blown away.
He had written all of the songs himself in Jalpari?
I have no idea because, you know, I was working as a producer. But I asked him this question. He said, like, it was more like a jam sort of thing. So I don't know exactly. I think
what's
he'd
your
be able
favorite
to
song that. Of that album?
Of that album, it'll probably be either Wo Lamhe or Jaage Hain, Soye Nahi.
Fair enough. So, wo Jal ke saath copyright issue chal raha tha. To, do you remember that? What was your take on the whole thing? In Pakistan, I think it's a big issue of copyright music, and Khurram bhai is very vocal about this, as you would know. So he was very aggressive on this issue. So what's your take on it?
I have no idea. I mean, you can't really decide unless you have all the facts. Copyrights is something like, you know, ki court mein decide hote hain ki kaun kiska hai. Two people are claiming ki mera hai, meri property hai. So of course, only courts can decide. I don't have enough facts to make up my own mind.
So Jal aur Atif ka court pe hua tha, wo didn't go to court?
No idea. No idea.
So, you're being so diplomatic.
No, I'm not being diplomatic at all. I just don't know. Mere paas ne facts hi nahi hai.
Okay,
mere paas ek side ki story hogi, dusri side ki nahi. So how can I take one side?
So then Atif went and made Duri. I think he made that in India, correct?
Yes, he made it.
And then he came back and then he made Meri Kahani with you again. So how would you compare the album, and especially how would you compare Atif and Jalpari versus Atif and Meri Kahani?
as a singer, kafi evolve ho gaya tha by meri kahani. He had explored different tones and textures of his voice, and he started incorporated all those in the album. So kafi mature album tha. Even songwriting bhi bade mazey ki thi. And baki logon ke bhi kafi input tha, Farhad Humayun ka, Mahmood Rehman ka, Sameer ka, myself. So kafi interesting collaborative album thi thi. With a very interesting sound. Yeah, achhi thi. Maturity aa rahi thi beech mein.
Meri Kahani lekin commercially did not perform as well as the other two, right? Is that a reason why Atif doesn't release an album since and he goes for singles now?
Maybe that's the reason. Ek to us zamane mein wo bhi kuch issues ho gaye the, if you remember, jab Meri Kahani aaya tha to us waqt ke us zamane mein suicide bombing bahut zyada shuru ho gayi thi,
security bahut zyada.
Exactly. Uske saath saath wo bhi ho gaya tha, kya kehte hain, Benazir was also assassinated during that time. Political, all of those things were happening. Political instability bhi thi, to wo sab focus jo hai na news channels pe chala gaya tha. Music sort of died down a little.
That's probably also why commercially Meri Kahani ka itna performance thi as compared to the other two albums as well.
Exactly. Wo udhar se dip aa gaya tha hamari puri music ke scene mein, if you notice.
लेकिन अब ये भी देखिए कि उससे अब it's been 12 years and there's been no fourth album. So is this a personal choice, Atif, कि वो singles, you want to work on singles rather than a full album?
I know that मतलब we recorded an album together. This is basically in 2010, 9 and 10. It was Atif, Ehsan Parvez, myself and Sameer Shami. So we did record an album. He's never released it. I don't know if he's going to release it. I know that he's also recorded quite a few songs with his existing band, Zan Ali and others. But I don't know.
Are you not part of that band?
No, I'm not a part of his band anymore. I left the band in 2016.
How come?
बस वो असल में इधर फैमिली की तरफ से था. My parents-in-law, they passed away. And ghar pe jo hai na mera rehna zara zaruri tha, because you know, my wife used to be alone with kids and it was becoming very difficult. The kids were also a pretty young, so
And let's move on from Atif. I have to talk about Naya Din by Saturn. How did you meet with Saturn? Naya Din is also another album which I really enjoyed. I think it was a great album. So, how did Saturn come to you? How was it working with them and producing Naya Din?
Right. So, basically, Salman and Shahbaz, they have a cousin. His name is Alamdar. And I knew Alamdar from Peshawar, and he introduced me to them, or them to me. They came over, we recorded one song, which was a metal song. Raak was the first song we recorded. We recorded Raak and it went very well. I really enjoyed working with them. They're very talented people. And then they decided to do a full album and we worked on it. Fit tha. Very talented people.
So I want to ask a couple of things from Naya Din. First being ke Shahbaz bhai ke jo vocals the, it fit in the album, but generally rock music or heavy music mein thodi zyada screaming ya thodi zyada grit hoti, aggressiveness. So he was very melodic. So how was what was the thought process in the production side of things on his vocals?
Right. So matlab you will find those variations in European music as well, jahan pe melodic metal type ki cheezein hoti hain. But as a producer, I don't really like to change things too much, you know. Jo ek essence hota hai kisi band ka, usko main chhedna nahi chahta. To wo ek melodic uske the, vocals and heavy music tha, and it was a good blend.
Contrasted well.
Yeah, it
contrasted. But it was different. Isliye I thought it was interesting to ask
exactly.
So kal Salman bhai se aur detail mein baat hogi. I've also read on your Wikipedia that you worked on the Mola Jutt soundtrack. Is that true?
Yeah, that's correct. I scored the whole
thing. That experience as compared to working, producing with Atif or like other bands, how was it compared to a soundtrack?
It was a very challenging experience because it was my first feature film. Bahut challenging experience tha and I had a lot of learning to do. So maine bahut zyada tutorials dekhe, books padhi, studied and analyzed a lot of scores and how they were working with visuals and whatnot. And then I started doing it, attempted it. But the director was happy. Bilal Ashari was happy with my work. So, and I enjoyed working on it. So,
Hans Zimmer se koi inspiration thi? I love Hans Zimmer.
Absolutely, Hans Zimmer se bahut inspiration hoti hai.
Mola Jutt kab aa rahi?
I have no idea. I have the same
it's
question.
It's been delayed so much.
But see, COVID ki wajah se it was going to get released in April last year. No, sorry, this year. April this year. But COVID lockdown ho gaya and then rest is history.
Pretty much. Okay. How was your Coke Studio experience last year? You were a musician again. So how did you end up in Coke Studio? How was that entire experience? And how was it working for a house band as compared for your own band, say Rang or Qayaas?
Right. So it was a great, great experience. It was an amazing opportunity to be a part of the house band. I actually went there for something else, but I ended up playing the guitar. And experience kafi farak tha, matlab from your own band, because there you have to give have a different sort of direction, because you have someone's vision that you have to fulfill, rather than bringing your own unique flavor to every song.
Yeah, I understand.
So it's a different experience, a different outfit. But at the same time, it was lovely spending time with everyone over there. All the musicians were amazing. Ruhail Bhai was amazing. Yeah. Great, great experience.
Did your producer experience help in the artist ki jo vision thi song ki? Did that help in the house band? You get what I'm trying to say? Did the producer help you in that sense?
Absolutely, absolutely. As a producer, when you go back to being a musician, you approach it very differently and serve the song and play simpler things, stuff that works for the main element, which is the vocal. So definitely, that helped me a lot, extremely.
Okay, come to your solo stuff now. Is there any album on the cards?
No album, but plenty of singles. I'm working on one these days.
I love Haseen. Haseen ka, I think, two things. The melody is catchy as hell. I don't know. It's a pop melody. So I don't know where. And the guitar tone, the clean guitar tone is a really good contrast. How do you come up with the melody on Haseen and the guitar tone?
I don't know, it just came about itself. I was just jamming to these chords. I had the strumming pattern, and I just started jamming to them, and the melody came by itself.
So you made the guitars and the melody at the same time?
Yeah.
Okay. How long? That must have been pretty quick then. How long the whole song took?
It didn't take very long to write the song. Probably maybe 2 hours, 3 hours, 2 hours, yeah. I was done with the song.
Yeah, how long have we been singing for and when did you work out you could sing? Are you singing on Uspar? Are there any backup vocals on Uspar? Any harmonies?
I think I have. I don't remember exactly where. I don't remember.
But yeah,
I have to go and
Since when are you singing, and when did you know that you could sing?
I don't know if I can sing still, but I did take lessons, Indian classical lessons from Ustad Fateh Ali Khan's academy. And I did that for a year, and I really enjoy singing. I wish I could be a better singer. High notes is not an issue. It's like, it's not the high notes. High notes is not a problem. I've worked on it. I've bridged my passaggio, which is like, you know, a break that register? You have between your chest. I've worked on my register, and hopefully one day maybe I'll be able to sing better.
Mere basically koi nahi any tips and classes.
Gap lagti rehti hai.
Does he teach you?
Yeah, I mean, he's a natural, right? He's naturally great. I'm not like naturally a great singer, so I really had to work on it.
Umair bhai is untrained, right?
Yeah, he's untrained. He has taken some lessons, but generally he's untrained. Yeah.
What is for you in what is in the future for Sarmad Ghafoor as a musician and as a producer?
As a producer, I'm mostly working on commissioned projects, so I have no idea what's coming my way next. But as a musician, I plan to like release a lot of my solo material and also get into some non-vocal based music, like instrumentals or maybe, you know, stuff like that. Yeah.
So, any news on Amar's album?
No news. It's been recorded. He still has to track like 2 or 3 songs. I mean, the music is all done. He has to track his vocals. But I don't know when it's going to get completed, because he gets so much work that he's typically very busy.
Are you playing the guitar on that album?
No, I'm not. I'm just producing the album. Yeah, the
guitar. Who's in his band?
Zanpir Zada from Takatak.
Yes.
And Yusuf Rame, Isa on the bass, and Muhammad Ali Sahel on the guitars as well.
Okay. That's a nice band, a very young band.
Basically, Takatak.
Yeah, exactly. He's got the Takatak.
Except for Rame and Altamash. Yeah.
Yeah. Atif Aslam, any album on that front?
No idea. I met him a couple of days ago, but didn't really talk about
No music stuff.
No.
I guess you guys are friends.
Yes, we are friends.
And you also produce for Bilal Khan. Any album on that front?
I did. He does his own productions now. I only did his first album.
Okay, fair enough. And also that reminds me, Easy Paisa Rai mein aapka tha. Music, is any of that on Omar's album or not? Is that just a scoring thing?
No. Except for one song, which was Rabba, but that's like a heavy version. It's a totally different version. For Rahi, it was totally different. So.
And Rahi, is that not on his album as well?
Rahi, he was planning to release all that music, but let's see when that happens, or if that happens.
That's not very good to hear as a fan.
Kya kare? Not in my hands.
Well, the first episode or second episode, the heavy riffs, were they yours?
Which album?
Easy Paisa Rahi ki baat karo. Pehle episode tha, second episode tha. There were some very heavy riffs, distorted riffs. Is that all you?
Yeah. That's all me.
Is that a full track or is it utna sahi hai?
No. They're just cues, you know. Portion ke liye heavy music chahiye.
Achha, the pura song nahi hai wo. I was like, I want to hear this song.
So, I mean, if there is something, we can always make a song out of it.
Exactly. Chale, Sarmad bhai, that's all I have for you. Thank you for your time. And,
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're such a vast career. I tried to fit all of it in one interview, but
yeah, that's great. Lovely talking to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.